Thank you. May grace and peace be with you all in the Holy Church of God. Beloved brothers and sisters, we have gathered here with joy to dedicate a new altar by celebrating the Lord's sacrifice. Let us join in these sacred rites with fervent hearts, listening to God's word with faith and sharing joyfully at the Lord's table. Let us raise our hearts toward the blessed hope. As we come together at one altar, we draw near to Christ, the living stone, in whom we grow into a holy temple. But first, let us humbly call upon God that in his kindness he may be pleased to bless this water he has created, with which we are to be sprinkled as a sign of repentance and a remembrance of baptism, and by which this new altar will be purified. O God, through whom every creature comes forth into the light of life, you accompany all people with such great love that not only do you nourish them with fatherly care, but you mercifully cleanse them of their sins with the dew of charity and constantly lead them back to Christ the head. For in your merciful plan, you establish that those who descend as sinners into the sacred waters to die with Christ should rise free from guilt and be made his members, heirs with him to an eternal reward. Sanctify, therefore, with your blessing, this water which you have created, that sprinkled on us and on this new altar, it may be a sign of the cleansing waters of salvation in which we have been washed in Christ and made a temple of your Spirit. Grant that with all our brothers and sisters who will celebrate the divine mysteries at this altar, we may come at last to the heavenly Jerusalem through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Oh,
May God, the Father of mercies, to whom we dedicate this new altar on earth, grant us remission of sins and allow us to offer the sacrifice of praise for all eternity at his altar on high, we pray. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who willed to draw all things to your Son lifted high on the altar of the cross, fill your church, we pray, with heavenly grace as she dedicates to you this altar, the table at which you will plentifully nourish the faithful that you gather as one, and will shape day by day, through the outpouring of the Spirit, a people consecrated to yourself. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The desert and the parched land will exult. The steppe will rejoice and bloom. They will bloom with abundant flowers and rejoice with joyful song. The glory of Lebanon will be given to them, the splendor of Carmel and Sharon. They will see the glory of the Lord, the splendor of our God. Strengthen the hands that are feeble. Make firm the knees that are weak. Say to those whose hearts are frightened, be strong, fear not. Here is your God. He comes with vindication, with divine recompense. He comes to save you. Then will the eyes of the blind be opened, the ears of the deaf be cleared. Then will the lame leap like a stag, then the tongue of the mute will sing. Those whom the Lord has ransomed will return and enter Zion singing, crowned with everlasting joy. They will meet with joy and gladness. Sorrow and mourning will flee. The word of the Lord.
Thanks.
from the letter of St. James. Be patient, brothers and sisters, until the coming of the Lord. See how the farmer waits for the precious fruit of the earth. Be patient with it until it receives the early and late rains. You too must be patient. Make your hearts firm, because the coming of the Lord is at hand. Do not complain, brothers and sisters, about one another, that you may not be judged. Behold, the judge is standing before the gates. Take as an example of hardship and patience, brothers and sisters, the prophets who spoke in the name of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be in your heart and on your lips, that you may make holy the gospel. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When John the Baptist heard in prison of the works of the Christ, he sent his disciples to Jesus with this question: Are you the one who is to come, or should we look for another? Jesus said to them in reply, Go and tell John what you hear and see. The blind regain their sight, the lame walk, lepers are cleansed, the deaf hear, and the dead are raised, and the poor have the good news proclaimed to them. And blessed is the one who takes no offense at me. As they were going off, Jesus began to speak to the crowds about John. What did you go out to the desert to see? A reed swayed by the wind? Then what did you go out to see? Someone dressed in fine clothing? Those who wear fine clothing are in royal places. Then why did you go out? To see a prophet? Yes, I tell you, and more than a prophet, this is the one about whom it is written. Behold, I am sending my messenger ahead of you. He will prepare your way before you. Amen, I say to you, among those born of women, there is none no greater than John the Baptist. Yet the least in the kingdom of heaven is greater than he. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We hear scriptures that tell us of the human life that we experience every day. We hear Jesus speaking about John the Baptizer, who has asked Jesus, as it were. He says, you go ask Jesus if he is the one for whom we are waiting. Ask him if he is the one. And Jesus, when the messengers come to him, he knows John is asking, are you ready to take your responsibility as I took responsibility in my prophetic work? Isn't that something we have people always, well, always needy of responding in that way? Yes, I'm ready, I'm willing. I have this responsibility. It may be a sacrifice, but I will do it. I have this responsibility. I didn't ask for it, but God has given it to me. And that can be in anywhere. I remember this wonderful lady. She was in one of my parishes, and she had a son. And when the son was about 7 years old, he had an accident, and he fell with a pencil, and it blinded him. And she prayed. She told us the story, and she told it to all of the people at one of these retreats we were having. She said, God, how can you ask me to take care of a blind child? What am I going to do? I don't know how to do this. God, why did you ask me to do this? And she said, she heard this little voice say, I didn't ask you. And that was the moment she was able to say, I will take this responsibility. And her son Patrick became the star of the school, and everywhere he went, he carried his Braille machine, and fellow classmates all through the rest of his elementary years, they would help him out, they would be with it. He was the star of the school. And then he went on to high school, and then to college. Patrick, the gift of God, whom his mother Martha never realized she would be responsible for. But she said yes, and light was given to the blind. An interior light and an ability to continue into a future that she would have asked God for any son, any child she would have. You know, we listened as James in the second reading said, patience, patient, you got to be patient. And I think of how many times people said to me, you know, Rome wasn't built in a day, when I would get impatient. And that was pretty interesting. Rome wasn't built in a day. And you say, boy, look at all that stuff that they did. It must have taken at least a week. And if you ever had any work done in your house, you know the trades are called here, there, and everywhere. And the trades are, oh, I need this right away. Hold your horses. I got 47 jobs waiting. I'll get there as soon as I can. Or they'll say, I'll be there at 10 o'clock. Did you mean morning or night? Be patient. I always say, the folks in the trades, we have to understand. We got to be patient because they're called and they're running this way and that. James says, be patient. Rome wasn't built in a day, we say. And then I think of how I was told, well, my mother used to say, I've only got two hands. And then they used to say, a watched pot never boils. Ain't it the truth? I still make the coffee on the stove. It's the best. All those other things, it's never hot enough. You cook it on the stove the way, with a percolator, unbelievable. But you put it on a flame and you're waiting. It's not perking yet. Let me go over here. The minute you walk out of the room, you hear it going all over the place. Oh, yeah. We're all in the same boat. We are brothers and sisters growing in our Father's house, with Holy Mother Church making sure everything is ready, everything is prepared. Our Father's house, Mother Church. What a beautiful family we become. But we have to be patient. Patient with ourselves, patient with each other. Not squander the grace, but be ready when it comes. When God says, I didn't ask you. I need you to do this. Are you the one who is to come? God asks us that all the time. Are you the one who is to come? Because we are the body of Christ, we have to say, you go tell John, the deaf hear, the blind see, the poor have the good news preached to them. In many ways, we are part of doing all of those things, giving hope, giving encouragement, giving strength, being merciful, forgiving, so that people don't give up, but instead give their best, saying, if you trust me, I'll try again. And so, that is why in our church there stands a place of sacrifice, specially arranged in such a way, coming from the very Bible, from the Old Testament, where God said that they should build an altar. And wherever the prophets or the patriarchs went, they would make that place holy by setting up stones to make an altar, a remembrance. God was here. This place is sacred always. And so it is that the church continues to provide the altar of sacrifice. I like to refer to it as the table and the tomb. The table because it reminds us of Holy Thursday when Jesus had the Passover with his friends, his disciples. And there they had all of the things of Passover, and Jesus took bread and said, this is my body which will be given up for you. Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body which will be given up for you. And taking the chalice of wine, he said, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Ah. The sacrifice is being prepared, but be patient. Be merciful. See it come to pass. The table, yes, but it must be seen also as the tomb. Otherwise, saying, this is my body which will be given up for you, but I'm not going to go through with crucifixion. It's just bread. The sacrifice, the fulfillment of the promise, that is what makes it sacred and holy. He gave himself completely on the altar of the cross, we say. This is my body, which is given up for you. Father, forgive them. They know not what they do. This day you will be with me in paradise. Here, the sacrifice of his own body and blood, as he said, it is finished. And he gave up his spirit on the altar of the cross. And his body was taken down from the cross and placed on a slab, a stone slab. In the tomb that was prepared by Joseph of Arimathea. There his body rested. See now the table of Holy Thursday. See now the cross where the sacrifice is complete. And I like to tell people, when you hear that snap of the host being broken, let that sacrifice resound in your heart and in your hearing. This is my body which is given up for you. As his body lay on that slab, see how the Holy Eucharist is placed on this altar. Nothing else should be on the altar. Oh yes, the cloths that remind us of the shroud that wrapped him. Oh yes, the corporal that is laid out to receive the body of Christ in the Holy Eucharist and any crumbs that might fall to be gathered up. How sacred, how holy. Yes, we need the book to be able to say the proper prayers, but we don't put a notebook on there or something that, well, we're using it now, I have no place else to lay it, I'll put it there. Oh no. This is the sacred place where the body of Christ rested until Easter morning. And on Easter morning, there was the angel or the young man dressed in white or the two angels speaking to saying, why do you look for the living one among the dead? He is not here. He has been raised up. Go into Galilee where you will see him. And this is the tomb of resurrection. The place where the risen Christ stepped forward and said, peace, peace, my peace I give to you. Do you know that during the Lamb of God, when you hear that crack, a small portion of that host is held over the chalice in anticipation. And when it is placed or dropped into the chalice, as it must be, it is the resurrection, the reunification of body and blood, the living Christ. There, that moment of resurrection, there we begin to know the angels were there to say, he is not here, he has been raised up. And that moment of the commingling of the body and blood of Christ is the moment of resurrection. How blessed, how good. There is the sturdy, everlasting presence of Jesus Christ, to whom we come with our prayers, before which we kneel here at this altar, which is made by human hands in patient, careful work, that each item, each detail would be just so. This enduring stone, polished, that will be the resting place for the body of Christ and the place from which the risen Christ will always stand and say, peace be with you. It took time. It took love. It took faith. It fulfills the scriptures. Is this the one for whom we are to look, or is there another? This is the altar in the church. This is the place, the one to whom we look, Jesus Christ. This is where our faith finds the fullness of its meaning. As Father pointed out, we celebrated a baptism by sprinkling it with water, holy water, recalling baptism. We will anoint it with oil and smear the sacred chrism of confirmation, the anointing of priest, prophet, and king, as Scripture says. We will celebrate the descent of the Holy Spirit, consecrating that which has been set apart. Incense will be burned and the smoke will rise up as our prayers and as our offering to the Father of Jesus, his Son, rises to the heavens, lifting our prayers, our very being, to the heavenly places, mingling with the guardian angels of each one filling this church. Each guardian angel praying with us, each one leading us carefully to God. We are a sacramental church. We will see the altar then covered and clothed in white garment, the white linen altar cloth, we will receive then Holy Communion, the body and blood of Christ from this sacred stone. How good is God to call together his people from north and south, east and west, to gather at this altar here on earth, praying that a holy angel will bring this sacrifice to the majesty of God's altar in heaven. And here, heaven and earth are united. Well, I've talked long enough. We are a sacramental church. A homily is helpful, but it must not be the heart of our worship. A homily is to lead us now to the fullness of the sacrifice, the table and the tomb, the Holy Eucharist, the gift of everlasting life. Amen. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit
was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man.
For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in one Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life,
who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come.
Beloved brothers and sisters, let our prayers ascend to God the Almighty Father through Jesus Christ, to whom all the saints are joined as sharers in his suffering and companions at his table. At this time, we invoke the presence of all the saints, the heavenly court to gather around, prophets and saints, martyrs, confessors, holy men and holy women, all who have now attained the glory of the heavenly kingdom. We pray the litany of saints that they may be with us now.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us.
Saint Michael, Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Peter and Saint Paul,
pray for us.
Saint Andrew,
pray for us.
Saint John,
pray for us.
Saint Patrick,
pray for us.
Saint Mary Magdalene,
pray for us.
Stephen. mysteries of Lisieux.
Pray for us.
Saint Ignatius of Antioch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lawrence.
Pray for us.
Pope Saint John Paul II.
Pray for us.
Saint Perpetua and Saint Felicity.
Pray for us.
Accept our petitions, we pray, O Lord. Through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints, so that this altar may be a place where the great mysteries of salvation are accomplished, and where your people offer you gifts, make known their desires, pour out their prayers, and bring forth every sentiment of worship and devotion through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
We glorify you, Lord, and we bless you for your ineffable sacrament of your love. You have decreed that the mystery of the altar should be brought to fulfillment in Christ, to whom all types and shadows give way. For Noah, a second father of the human race, once the flood had receded, set up an altar to you and offered a sacrifice, which you, Father, accepted as a pleasing fragrance, thereby renewing your covenant of love with the human race. Abraham, our father in faith, clinging to your word with all his heart, constructed an altar so that, not sparing Isaac, his beloved son, he might be pleasing to you. Moses, too, the mediator of the old law, built an altar, which, sprinkled with the blood of a lamb, would mystically prefigure the altar of the cross. All this Christ has fulfilled in the Paschal mystery. For by ascending the tree of the cross as priest and victim, he handed himself over to you, Father, as a pure oblation, so that the sins of the whole world might be blotted out and a new and eternal covenant be made with you. Therefore, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, pour forth from heaven your sanctifying power upon this altar built in the house of your church, that it may be an altar dedicated for all time by the sacrifice of Christ and stand as the Lord's table, where your people are refreshed by the divine banquet. This stone, cut and shaped, let it be for us a sign of Christ, from whose pierced side flowed blood and water by which we were established, the sacraments of the church. Let this be a festive table to which the guests of Christ hasten with joy, so that casting on their cares and burdens, they may gain new strength of spirit for new paths ahead. Let it be the place of intimate communion with you and a place of peace, where those who feed on the body and blood of your Son may be filled with his spirit and grow in your love. Let it be the source of the church's unity and of fraternal harmony, where your faithful, gathering as one, may drink of the spirit of mutual charity. Let it be the center of our praise and thanksgiving until we come jubilant to the eternal dwellings, where we are to offer you the sacrifice of unending praise with Christ, the high priest and living altar, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
May the Lord, by his power, sanctify this altar by which by our ministry we anoint, so that as a visible sign it may express the mystery of Christ, who offered himself to the Father for the life of the world.
Thank you.
Let our prayers, O Lord, rise like incense in your sight. And as this house is filled with a pleasing fragrance, so let your church be fragrant with the aroma of Christ.
Thank you.
May the light of Christ shine upon the table of this altar, and may those who share the Lord's Supper shine with his light.
Rejoice, rejoice, believers, number 730 in your St. Michael hymnal.
As in exaltation, we acclaim. Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in the hope of well-being and health, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, order our days in your peace, and command that we may be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen.
Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who those sinners, hoping your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours. Forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirits.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter
under my roof, but only say a word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is Behold the Lamb in your St. Michael hymnal number 454.
Come to where we live, God, I thank you.
Let us pray. Keep us, O Lord, ever close to your altar, where the sacrament of sacrifice is celebrated, so that united in faith and charity, we who by Christ are nourished into Christ may be transformed, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Do you like it?
When I was here in confessions yesterday, I was kind of peeking through the window of the confessional and looking upon the new sanctuary, and I just felt this childlike joy, this excitement to be able to offer this to the Lord and to have the privilege of celebrating Mass here. So it's a beautiful moment for the life of our parish. I'd like to thank Bishop Libasci, the shepherd of our diocese, for celebrating such a beautiful Mass, for beautiful reflection. And Bishop told me before Mass that this is his first time dedicating an altar in this diocese. So that's what a privilege we have to celebrate this rite with you. Yep, thank you. And I'd like to acknowledge our wonderful music ministry who somehow fit this in, the beautiful music for this morning's Mass in the midst of a very busy time. It really helped lift our prayers up to heaven. I'd like to thank the volunteers who helped assemble this all on Friday. Miraculously, we lifted up a 500-pound stone on that altar with no stubbed fingers, which was amazing. And Bernie, can you raise your hand real quick? Yeah. Bernie Hammond's a friend of mine, and he's a parishioner of Holy Rosary Parish in Rochester, where I served as a deacon my last year of the seminary. And Bernie, without template or blueprint, built this amble and that altar by hand. And yeah. And it's a testament to his skill, but more importantly, it's a testament to his faith. Because Bernie loves the Mass and he loves the Holy Church. So these are monuments to his faith and his love. And then finally, please join us after Mass. We'll have some cake and homemade baked goods and refreshments downstairs. So please join us.
Who made the coffee? Wonderful. Congratulations and thank you so much, Father David, for all that you've done. And for the servers and everyone today, thank you. God bless you and many happy and blessed years to you all. Give him a little hand. He does. Anyway. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
May God, who adorns you with a royal priesthood, grant that as you exercise it in holiness, you may share worthily in the sacrifice of Christ, we pray. Amen. And may he who gathers you at one table and renews you with one bread make of you one heart and one soul, we pray.
Amen.
By the example of your love, may you draw to Christ those to whom you proclaim him, we pray.
Amen.
And may the peace and blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit descend upon you, remain forever and ever.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil.
May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls.
Amen. In closing, let us go forth singing, O Come Emmanuel, in your Saint Michael hymnal, number 652.